Hey, what's going on, everyone? In this video, we're going to take a look at how we can use timelines in blueprints to affect properties of our blueprints over time. To do this, we are in the Blueprint Third Person project with starter content enabled. And let's go ahead and get started. What I'm going to do is hop over to the modes panel over here, and I'm going to grab an empty actor. I'm just going to drag, left click, and drag and drop that into our level here. And get out of rotation mode really quickly. And what we're going to do is add some components to it and then turn it into a blueprint and add script to it. So with our empty actor here, let's start adding some components. The first that we're going to need is a scene component so that we can manipulate the transform of this actor. And we're going to call this the root. Next thing I'm going to add is a point light. So I'm going to go ahead and select the point light here. Going to move it up off the floor a little bit. Going to change some settings for it. Let's change the color. I'm going to make it a gold, somewhat gold color, like something like that. And I'm also going to turn off cast shadows for this. We'll show you why in a moment. The next thing I'm going to do, let's add a static mesh component. And we're going to use the shape wedge B, which is here in our content browser. And let's just move it up just a little bit and rotate it by hitting E, something like this, 90 degrees, something like that. Let's actually scale it down as well. Make sure your lock icon is set. Let's set this to 0.5 all around. And one more thing we need to do, let's change the material. Let's just make it gold. So that looks like a piece of cheese, right? This is going to be our cheese pickup actor. What we're going to do is use a timeline to change the brightness of this light over time so that it flickers, and then it also will move it up and down. Now for the rotation, luckily there is a rotating movement component. That's it. There's a rotating movement component, which is cool because if I simulate right now, let's go to this drop down and I simulate, you can see it already starts to rotate our little pickup actor for us. But what we want to have it do is also move up and down and affect the brightness. We actually want to slow down that rotation because that's kind of fast. So I'm going to click our rotating movement component here. And in the rotation rate for the yaw, you can see it's spinning at 180 degrees. Let's bump that down to, say, 25 degrees maybe. And it's moving a lot slower, actually. Let's try 45. So I'm going to click our rotating movement again, set that to 45, and simulate. What is it? Alt-S? Is that what it is? Yep, Alt-S. And that looks better. And once we get it going up and down, I think it'll look more like a pickup. So there we go. We have the basis for our pickup. Let's go ahead and create a blueprint out of it now and add some script. So click the Blueprint Add Script button. And for the name, let's just call it Pickup. And hit the Create button. And there you go, there's our blueprint created and a new tab has been opened for us. And there are all of our components now inside the blueprint editor on the viewport tab. We're gonna hop over to the event graph so we can provide the scripted functionality for it here in this graph. Gonna right click and drag past these default nodes as we won't need those. And let's right click and scroll all the way down to the bottom and there is a add timeline option. Now the timeline node, as the tooltip suggests here, allows for values to be keyframed over time, which is exactly what we want. So go ahead and select that, and you'll be prompted to enter a name for this timeline. We'll just call it the movement timeline. And you can see on this node there are several pins, end pins. We're not going to worry about any of those. You could have some custom events or functions that feed into these that play it, stop it, and reverse it. We're just going to autoplay this and have it loop. And let's go ahead and do that actually right now. So you can double click on the timeline to open it up in the timeline editor. And here is where we can add our tracks and the keyframes that will serve on those tracks to update our properties. Now there's a couple different tracks that you can add. You can add a float track, a vector track, an event, or a color track. For us, we're just going to worry about the float and the vector track. So we'll start out with the float track. Go ahead and click the Add Float Track button. It's going to prompt you for a name. We're going to go ahead and call this the Brightness, because this is going to serve as the brightness for our light. And inside the track here, go ahead and hold Shift and left click to add a keyframe. Now it doesn't matter wherever you do it, because you'll have the opportunity to enter in values for those, which we're actually going to do. For your first keyframe, set the time and the value to 0. So at 0, the brightness will also be 0. Hold Shift and left click again to add another keyframe. For the time, go ahead and set that to 1. And the value, go ahead and set that to 5,000, actually. Now it's going to look like your keyframe disappeared. You can click these two icons here to kind of center it back up. And there you can see is our progression from 0 to 5,000 over 1 second. Hold Shift again and left click one more time and set the value to 2 seconds and the value back down to 0. Now if you center it up again by clicking these two icons, you'll see we get the movement that we want on this track from 0 to 5,000 and back to 0. And let's hold Control and select each of our keyframes. Make sure that they are all selected. There'll be a goldish color to indicate that they are selected. Right click on a keyframe and choose the auto key interpolation. And when we do that, you'll see we'll get a more smooth in and out transition between our keyframes, which is what we want. So with that, let's set our length to 2 seconds as well, just for clarity, so we can see the end of our movement here. And while we're at it, go ahead and use the last keyframe. We're going to autoplay this timeline, and we are also going to have it loop. Don't worry about replicated, that's for networking, which we're not going to be doing any of for now. And with that, the brightness track is ready to go. Go ahead and click the vector track now to add a new vector track. And as you guessed it, it's pretty much similar to what we just did. Let's just call this the Z movement, because we're only going to worry about moving it up and down along the Z. So to do that, you can see we have our X, Y, and Z values here. We're actually going to hide the X, hide the Y, and lock both of them just to make sure we don't add keyframes for those, because we only want to worry about the Z. And hold the shift button and left click to add a keyframe. Again, 0 and 0 for our values. Shift again and left click at 1 second time. For our value, we'll set this to, I don't know, 50 maybe. That might be too much. We'll see in a moment. And hold shift and left click one more time. 2 seconds and back down to 0. Now, if we use our zoom in and zoom out again, you could see there is our movement that we want. Same as before, control and hold and left click to select each of our keyframes. Right click on one and choose auto. And there is that movement that we want again. So our timeline is complete. We can actually close it now. And once we hop back to the event graph, you can see that our timeline node has been updated. We now, in the upper right-hand corner of the timeline, can see that it's set to loop and autoplay. And you can see that two new pins have been added to represent the two tracks that we added. So with that, we can hop over to the My Blueprint tab now. We can hold Control and drag in our point light here. And then we can drag off of our point light with the left mouse button. And we want to set intensity. We're going to set the intensity of the light, or the brightness. But I think it's referred to as intensity in the engine here. We're then going to grab our update pin and connect it to the intensity so that it continually updates our set intensity as the timeline progresses. And we're also going to get the value of our brightness here and connect that to our new intensity value so that our light is continually updated with our brightness from our track that we specified. Last bit of business we need to do, let's hold Control and drag in our shape wedge here, our static mesh, and let's drag off of that. And we want to set the location of our wedge. We want to set the relative location of our wedge. So drag that up and connect like so. And then just grab your Z movement pin and connect it to the new location. Now, once we compile and save and hop back to our level here, if we simulate, you should see that our little cheese piece here is going up and down and rotating around. Now we can move this up a little bit like so and have it floating higher or lower, whatever we want. And that is going to wrap it up for this video. Now you know how to affect the properties of a blueprint over time using a timeline in multiple ways. You could use this video in conjunction with the blueprint pickup video as well earlier in this series to create a pickup now out of this blueprint. Hope you guys enjoyed this video, and we will see you next time.